reproduction in animal, and in the first part of this chapter we have discussed about sexual reproduction in animals. Okay, we have discussed fertilization, then external and internal fertilization, and all the fertilization process in human beings. Okay, now in the second part of this chapter we are going to discuss about the asexual reproduction in animals. Okay, I hope you remember asexual reproduction in case of plants. Okay, so as the name suggests, asexual means the process which do not require fertilization. Fertilization process do not occur in case of asexual reproduction. Why? Because only single parent is involved in whole process of reproduction in case of asexual reproduction. Okay, so no gamete will form and no fertilization will be there in case of asexual reproduction. So far we have learned about reproduction in familiar animals, but what about very small animals like hydra, like amoeba? In all those microscopic animals, the process of reproduction is carried out through the process of asexual means. Okay, now let us study the asexual reproduction in case of hydra. This is the body of the hydra. Okay, such kind of reproduction in which the body part cut off from the main parent part, such kind of reproduction is known as budding. Okay, so in your 8th class only two type of processes are given in NCERT book, though many more types of reproduction processes are there which we will discuss in higher class. So let us study the process of budding in hydra. Okay, and this is the main parent body. Small bud like structure occur at any part of the body of the parent cell, parent body. Then after the growth, that bud will grow in the proper size, and then it will cut off from the main parent body and it will develop as the whole new individual. Okay, but the new bud which is formed from the main parent bud is exactly copy of the parent bud. Okay, so this is the property of asexual reproduction, that the offspring is exact copy of parent cell. Okay, of parent body. Now in each hydra there may be one or more bulges. Okay, these bulges will develop into bud, and that bud will develop into adult. These bulges are developing into new individual, and they are known as buds. Recall the presence of bud in yeast. We have discussed all these processes in case of plants in class 7th. Okay, in hydra too, new individual develop as outgrowth from the single parent. This type of reproduction in which only single parent is involved is called asexual reproduction. Okay, no new individual develop from the bud in hydra. This type of, since new individual develop from the bud in case of hydra, such kind of asexual mode of reproduction is known as budding. Okay, this is first kind of asexual reproduction in animals. Second kind of asexual reproduction involves division of parent into two parts. Okay, such kind of asexual reproduction occur in case of amoeba. Okay, as we know that shape of amoeba is irregular, so what happen in case of amoeba? First of all, amoeba will divide its nucleus into two parts, and then it will divide its whole body into two new individual, and they are known as daughter amoebae. Here daughter does not mean, which is the normal meaning of daughter in English language. Here daughter means offspring. In case of asexual reproduction, we write daughter as offsprings. Okay, it has nothing related to female or male. Here daughter means offspring. Okay, offspring which are exact copy of the parent body. Okay, so you already learned about structure of amoeba, irregular structure. So far you have been relating amoeba with the pseudopodia, but now this is new thing with which you can relate amoeba. Such kind of division in which parent divide into two daughter cell is known as binary fission. As you know that binary means two. You are aware of binary language in computer in the same way, because in that language only 0 and 1 numbers are related. In the same way, here the binary fission involves two division. That's why, and fission means division. Okay, so binary fission means division of parent body into two new individuals. This is followed by division of the body into two parts. Okay, each part receives one nucleus and it will grow as parent body. And two amoebae are produced from one parent amoeba. Okay, amoeba is plural, amoeba. reproduction in which animal produced by dividing into two new daughter cell is known as binary fission. Okay, now let us study the story of a Dolly. It's the first cloned animal. What is cloning? Cloning is a production of exact copy of the cell from any living part of the body. Okay, any living part of the body is that we just take out any body part, any living cell, and then we form new individual, and this process is known as cloning. Cloning of an animal was successfully performed for the first time by the scientist Ian Wilmer. Okay, he is a Scottish scientist. What he did, he cloned the nucleus of two sheep. Okay, first one was Finn Dorset sheep, and second one was Scottish Blackface ewe. Okay, he cloned these two sheep and he produced new cloned sheep, that is Dolly. Okay, but during the process of cloning, Dolly, a cell, was collected from the mammary gland of female Finn Dorset sheep. Simultaneously, egg was obtained from Scottish Blackface ewe also. The nucleus was removed from egg and then he made them to fuse together. Then the nucleus of mammary gland cell from the Finn Dorset sheep was inserted into egg of the Scottish ewe, okay, whose nucleus had been removed simultaneously. The egg thus produced was implanted into Scottish Blackface ewe. Okay, so the mother who produced this Dolly was Scottish Blackface ewe. Dolly was given birth by Scottish Blackface ewe. It was found that absolutely not at all absolutely identical to Finn Dorset sheep from which the nucleus was taken. Since nucleus of the egg of the Scottish Blackface ewe was removed, Dolly did not show any characteristic of Scottish Blackface ewe. Though the real mother of Dolly was Scottish Blackface ewe, but no characteristics were identical to that Scottish Blackface ewe, because that scientist has merged the two nucleus, and Dolly got all the characteristics from Finn Dorset sheep. Okay, Dolly was healthy clone of Finn Dorset sheep and produced several offspring of her own through the normal sexual means. Okay, unfortunately, Dolly died on 14th Feb 2003 due to lung diseases. Okay, since Dolly, several attempts have been made, but all those attempts were unsuccessful. Okay, because at one or any stage of the life, the clone ultimately died because of abnormalities. Okay, so this chapter is basically over. Now let us do NCERT questions. First one is, explain importance of reproduction. Reproduction is not essential for the single individual, but it is essential for survival of whole species. Okay, describe the process of fertilization in human being. For this part, you can refer the first part of the video. Choose the most appropriate answer. Internal fertilization occurs within the female body. Okay, tadpole develop into adult frog by the process of metamorphosis. Metamorphosis involves many life stages. What is the difference between metamorphosis and development in human case? In metamorphosis, the tadpole is completely different from the adult frog. But in case of human, the baby is having all the organ, but they grow in size. Okay, growth and metamorphosis are entirely different processes. Next is, number of nucleus present in zygote is 1. Okay, now true or false? First is, oviparous animals give birth to young one. False. Each sperm is a single cell. True. External fertilization takes place in frog. True. New human individual develop from cell called gamete. False. Egg laid after fertilization is made up of single cell. True. Amoeba produced by budding. False. Fertilization is necessary even in asexual reproduction. False. Binary fission is method of asexual reproduction. True. Zygote is formed as a result of fertilization. True. Amoeba, an embryo, is made up of a single cell. False. It is actually made up of combination of two type of cell. Okay, give two differences between zygote and fetus. Zygote is the stage in which we all the parts of the body is not clear, but in case of fetus, all the part of the baby are developed, so we can tell whether the baby is female or male. Okay. Plus, zygote is having single kind of cell, and fetus is having multicellular. Define asexual reproduction. The reproduction which involves single parent. Okay. Describe two method of asexual reproduction. You can describe binary fission and budding process. In which female reproductive organ does embryo get embedded? Fallopian tubes, oviducts. Okay. What is metamorphosis? Indirect development from tadpole to adult frog. Okay. Example, frog. Differentiate between internal fertilization and external fertilization. You can refer to the previous first part of this video for the answer. Okay. Now this chapter is over. Thank you, student. We will meet in next